Now today we are going to see a topic, thread priority. So same book we are going to follow, the Java Complete Reference as well as some other internet resources. And now here we have the thread priority concept. The meaning of normally priority means what? Priority is nothing but giving the preference, giving the highest preference. If you are giving the highest preference to them, that will be called as a priority, right? So in Java, normally the priorities can be given. A normal priorities for every thread will be in normal way. That is, the priorities will be defined from 0 to, the priority has to be defined from 1 to 10. Normal priority is nothing but 5. Minimum priority is nothing but 1. Maximum priority is nothing but 10. So let me discuss in detail with some examples about this thread priorities over here. So let me have a discussion about this one. So here is the thread priority, right? See, each thread we are having some sort of priorities. Each thread we are having a priority. Priority is nothing but some preference. Who will execute first? Who will be give the first priority? Who will give the next priorities? Normally, priorities in Java is represented between the range is 1 to 10. So this in most of the cases, we already we discussed about the thread scheduler, right? So who will be select the thread? So thread scheduler will be selected the threads based on the priority. If the priority value is whatever the assigning of the priority value is the highest priority, that will pick by this thread scheduler will pick that one, will select that thread and it will go for execution. So thread scheduler schedules the threads according to their priority. So if you have a 10 threads, thread 1 is 3, priority 3, thread 4, priority 5, thread 6, priority 8. Like highest priority, whichever we are having, that will be considered as the thread scheduler will consider that and that pick for execution. So this type of process, thread scheduler schedules the threads according to their priority, is called as primitive scheduling. Actually, we have two types of schedulings. Actually, we are having two types of scheduling. One is the non-primitive, that is one is primitive, preemptive. So here I'll just clear the drawing. Here we have discussed it here itself. Primitive. So preemptive and non-preemptive. Preemptive scheduling and second one is the non-preemptive scheduling. Okay, so in OS concept in the next semester, we'll learn about this preemptive, non-preemptive. This preemptive is going to be dealing with the total, the time period, which is scheduled for that one, which is scheduled. That is, we can use round robin algorithms here. That will be learned in the OS. No need to worry about that. And this is first come, first serve. First come, first serve algorithm. First come, first serve algorithm. So preemptive scheduling is nothing but round robin. Round robin is nothing but, like, it is allocated some priorities based on the priority, based on the arrival of the time. Arrival of that time, particular, say for example, you have got the appointment for 9 o'clock. So at 9 o'clock, you will be get the appointment, you have to take it. So once again, 9:10, another person has given the appointment. So once you have finished or may not be finished between the 9 to 9:10, your appointment and having concerned with the respective doctor and everything has finished within the 10 minutes, it's okay. If it's not finished, automatically after 9:10, the appointment has to be given to the next other person. Means once the time slot, whatever they have given, within the time slot, you have to be, the thread has to be executed. If it is not executed or may not be executed, it doesn't matter about that. Automatically, the thread scheduler will assign to the next time slot. Automatically goes to another. Like this, it will goes as a round robin. Once until it comes the next time in the circle, after the coming of that particular time of that particular thread, it has to be wait until that. Say for example, between 11 o'clock to 12 o'clock, the 10 or else we can call 6 threads are there. So first thread has given the time 11 to 11:10. Second thread has to given 11:10 to 11:20. Third thread 11:20 to 11:30. Like 11:30 to 11:40, 11:40 to 11:50, 11:50 to 12. 6 threads has given, these are the time slots. If the thread one has completed the task within the 11 to 11:10, may not be completed or completed, doesn't matter. After immediately 11:10, they automatically, the scheduler will assign the appointment to the thread 2 because the time has completed 11:10. Automatically, the thread 2 has to take care. The thread 2 also, it has to complete or may not be complete. after 11:20 thread 3 will be considered. So this will be comes again, goes like this round robin. If thread 1 is not completed within the 10 minutes, whatever the 11 to 11:10, again it has to wait up to the 12 to 12:10. That is a time slot. This is called as round robin. So that type of things will be considered as a preemptive scheduling. And non-preemptive is nothing but whoever come first, they will be take care of the access the resources or access the service. First come, first serve. Okay. So this threads according to their priority is known as preemptive scheduling, but it is not guaranteed because it depends on the JVM specification that which schedule it has chooses. So we have three constants in this priorities, three constants defined in the thread class. One is min priority, second one is normal priority, third one is max priority. All are defined as a public static int, all are integer values. So as I said, you 1 to 10 priorities, right? So minimum priority value is 1. The normal priority value is 10. And the normal minimum is 1, normal is 5, and maximum priority is 10. So by default, the thread priority is 5, normal priority. So these are the three constants it is available in thread class. That is min underscore priority, max underscore priority, norm underscore priority, where norm is nothing but normal priority. Okay. So let me have a discuss one more here, an example. Now see, this is an example. So already we have, you have remembered the methods, right? In the last class, we have discussed about some methods, how to know the thread name, how to know the priority of a thread, how to slip a thread into for a particular time. So what I'm doing here is I'm creating a class called as thread multi-priority one here and through the extend. So already you know how to create a thread by implementing the run method, that is runnable interface. We can implement the run method by implements with the help of runnable interface. We can create the threads or with the help of extends the thread. So this is the extends thread. Like this, we are creating a class called as text multi priority one. Now, whoever extends this thread, automatically, what is the condition that has to implement the run method? So in the run method, running thread name is how to know the thread method name, thread dot current thread dot get name. So these are the methods. This is a class. Current thread is a method to know the current thread executing, which is the current thread. Already we have discussed it in the last class, right? Current method. And to know the get the name of the thread, get name. So to access that one, class name dot the method name dot again the method name, the thread dot current thread dot get name. So to know the running thread name, to know the running thread priority, thread, that is class dot current thread dot get priority. So to know the current thread name, get name. To know the priority, get priority. Okay. So this is the method we are going to be using over this in this run method. So what are the methods we are going to be using to thread name? Thread dot current thread dot get name. How to know the priority of a thread? Current thread. Thread dot current thread dot get priority. Okay. So like this, we are going to be making sure about this one. And now we are going to be call the main method here. In this one, I'm creating the objects M1, M2. To whom? For this class. M1 for this class, we are going to create it. Now, set priority. We are going to create this. M1 is a thread object, right? M1 is one object and M2 is another object. So I'm just setting the priority. How to set the priority? With the help of these priorities, we can use it. That is set priority method we are using. So how to set the priority is thread dot min priority. For M2, I'm setting the priority as max priority. So what is the minimum value for this thread one? Priority is 1. The value for max priority is 10. Now when you start M1, and again it start M2. Now it has to be take care, it has to be execute, it has to take care of that. The thread 0. Thread 0 is going to be, the thread name is, first is thread 0. The maximum priority for the thread 0, because for which thread we have given the maximum priority, that will be run first. That is running thread is 10. Next will be run thread name 1. The priority of that one is 1, because this is the highest one that will be executed first. This is the next one. This will be executed next. So that will be taken care by this M1, M2. But even here you are called M1 and here we call M2. So based on the priority you set, first will be executed whoever has the first priority. And remember, it totally depends on the, here the point we said, totally depends on JVM specification that which scheduling it chooses. It depends on that. It may be said, select the preemptive schedules or it select the non-preemptive schedules based on that. Preemptive means whatever you are allocating, time intervals, like you are setting some time interval and some priorities you are allocating. Based on that, it will be executed. Or else, some JVMs will select the non-primitives, whichever come first. Say, come first means M1 has to come first. Even though it is has a low priority, it will be executed first. Again, M2. So this type of first come first serve is called as non-preemptive. The when you are setting the priority, when you are setting the priority means what? When you are giving some time intervals, it will be called as preemptive. So it depends on JVM how it will be executed. Now let me run this program so that you can understood clearly what we have discussed here. Now please make sure that how many methods we have learned here. We have seen current method, get name, get priority, set priority. These are the methods we have seen it. Okay. So let me run this program so that you can understood very clearly about this. So here is the program. So multi-thread here is test multi-thread. I'm just opening this program. So see, this is the code run, and this is the main creating objects, setting the priorities to priorities here and running. Okay. Now I'm opening the command prompt, cmd java c space, what is the name of the program? Test multi priority. This test multi priority dot java. If no errors, run the program. See, thread name is zero. That is, thread name is zero, thread name is one, and thread priority is one, thread priority is 10. When you again run this program, it is goes to thread one has executed. First is thread one has executed. Next, the priority of thread one is 10. Next, thread zero name, the priority is one. So like this, it depends. It depends on how it is going to be selected. Now again, I am running the program. Thread one has executed. First thread has executed. The priority of that thread is 10. And the name, next priority, next thread is zero has executed. The priority is one. So whichever has the highest priority is going to be considering that into based on that. Has many, many times when you are going to be coming into that one, that based on the JVM. JVM has to be decided which has to be executed first. When you are going to be executing this, see, first thread, the priority name is 10, 0, and priority is 1. So which one is executed? Actually, we in this program, we are calling M1 first. M1 means what? Minimum thread. So again, we are calling M2. But in this output, see, in this output, first is executed thread 1 with the priority 10. Next is executed thread 0, the priority with 1. Like this, it will be, we can set the priorities. For what purpose we are going to using this thing of making priorities means, after transaction only, the order has to be put for sending to the particular provider. Without payment success, you put the order means the priorities has changed. Like orders, the items has to be selected first, maybe in shopping, online shopping, whatever. You have to select the items. You have to see the cart, in the cart, see the bill, how much it is getting. For that bill only, the respective amount has to pay. Maybe cash on delivery or online, maybe pay or UPI, whatever. Without the total, the selected the items, without the total cost, whatever, first you pay, then purchase. It's not possible, right? Which one has the thread first? Selection of the thread, selection of the items, get the total. This is the first thread. Next thread is this banking. Without this, you can't make this one. So without the banking transaction, getting the confirmation, if the thread is saying that successfully ordered, like this, the message has said, then the threads are mismatching. So we have to make priorities, which one has to execute it first, which one has to execute it next, based on the priority only. And if you remember, those who have the habit of the online reservation, IRCTC, for moving from IRCTC website to the banking, they will give time slot. Do you remember that 10 minutes or 5 minutes they are giving? Within time, 10 minutes, you have to complete the transaction. Again, you have to come back here because the thread has to be, it is going to be blocked. It will be blocked, that seat. No one has to be book other people. Up to the 10 minutes, it will be blocked. After 10 minutes, it is automatically release that seat, release that booking because somebody has to block it. So the time slot it indicating is you are going to be making sure that within the time slot, you have to be complete that thread. Then only it is going to be give the chance to the other people. If you book, if you get success, no problem. For other people, they are saying no seats are available. For online movie tickets or for everything, the time slots will be considered. The time slot is based on the priorities. Okay. So that's about the topic. called as this priority threads. Okay.